Hello children, welcome to another class of computer lesson. So today we are going to learn the remaining portions in this chapter. So let's continue. So in our previous class, what are the things we have learned? At first we discussed about how to enter the data in a spreadsheet, how to select the data, etc. How to enter the data in a worksheet. We know worksheet means it consists of rows and columns. A grid of rows and columns is known as worksheet, and a collection of worksheet is known as workbook. Is it correct? Yes. So the next topic we are going to learn about is selecting data in the worksheet. Selecting data in the worksheet. Selecting data in the worksheet. So here, how to select the data in a worksheet? For example, this is our worksheet. Name. Then B, 60, 50. Okay. So, how to select the data from this worksheet? Right? Okay. So, there are some steps for selecting the data in this worksheet. First, there are two ways. First way is, click on the upper portion of the cell. First cell, click the upper end of the upper left end of the box means cell. Then drag it into the lower portion of that cell at the right of cell. First click here and then drag it into the end of this worksheet. So that means we can select the whole range of cells. That is the one way. Another way is just click on the first cell. Just click on the first cell and then press shift key. You can go to the right arrow and then down arrow. Then finally the whole cell of range of cells will be selected. Okay, so here click the mouse pointer in the upper left corner cell of this range. Drag the mouse to reach the lower right corner cell, or click on the first cell of the range and then press the shift key and click on the cell of the range, the entire range will be selected. So look at the page number 87. You can see there are some names and also their age. So if you want to select a particular column, first click on the upper right end, sorry left end, and then drag it to the lower right end. So you can select the whole range of cells. Okay. Then next is copying and moving of the data. Copying and moving of the data. Without deleting it. That means it remains in the original position, but we can copy of that data from that place to another place. data means original data remains in the first position. Original data or the data will remain in the original position. Data will remain in the original position. Original position. But a copy of data moved from that original position to another position. Copy of data moved from original position to another position. Okay, so once again, what is copying data means? We can copy the data from one position to another. That means copying data, data remain in the original position, and if the data remain in the original position, but a copy of data, we can move into the another location. So example, select the range of cells which you want to copy. To copy the data from one location to another. So let's do a simple example. So here, name, then age, then class. We know in the worksheet, column can be represented using letters A, B, C. And then rows are represented using one numbers 2, 3. So first name Arun, age 15. And class 9. Then second name Ishi, age 14 and class 8. Sabi 16 and a class 10. Then next year Ekta 18. And she is in the class plus 2. Okay. So here, this is the worksheet which contains some details of the students and their age, also their class. So there are 5 students, sorry, 4 students and their age and their class. So here, we have to copy the names of the students into another location. For example, this is the D column and these are the list of the students, and we want to copy the list of student names into the another one. So first of all, we have to select the name of the students. Okay. Then we know we have already discussed how to select the range of cells. Click on the upper left border and drag it into the lower right border or corner. Then we can select the whole range of cells, means whole data. So first of all, just select the list of students and then you can press Ctrl plus C. You can press Ctrl plus C or go to edit, then copy, edit, copy. Then after that, just click on the cell. That means to make the cell active by clicking the mouse pointer on the cell and then press Ctrl plus V or go to edit, paste, edit, paste, edit, copy, then edit, paste. What happens? So the whole data will paste into this cell, like this name, then Arun, then Ishi, then Sabi, then Ekta. Okay, so once again, how to copy a range of data from one place to another. So there are some steps. So let's see what are the steps. First, select the range of cells which you want to copy. Then click on contact. Then click on copy button. Then click in the cell where you want to the first entry of the selected data to be placed. Then click paste button. The selected data will be copied to that new location. So look at the picture, page number 88. So you can see, first select the range of data and then second one, click home tab. So you can see this, the picture of scissors, that is cut option, cut. And here below the scissor you can see a one option, that is copy option. And then click on the home tab, select copy, and then click the cell you want to paste that data, so that after clicking that cell, then Ctrl V or press Ctrl V or go to paste button. Finally, what happens? The whole data will be pasted into the new location. Next is moving the data. Something similar to copying data, but there is a slight difference. So moving the data. Moving the data. Next part is moving data. data will be moved from original location to some another location. That means, what is the difference between copying and moving? In copying, data remains in the original position. But in the case of moving data, the original data will be moved to another location without remaining in the original position. So now all of you understood what is the difference between copying data and moving data. Yes, moving data means we can move the data completely into the another location. So here the definition is, moving of data means the data will be moved from original location to some another location. So there are some steps for moving the data. First one, select the range of cells you want to move, and then second one, go to press Ctrl C or select cut option, click cut option, select, press Ctrl plus X or go to cut option, then go to home tab and then click paste option. Before that, have to click the cell you want to paste it. Same thing as that of copying data. So once again, first one, select the range of cells. Select the range of cells. Then second option, click home tab. Third one, click cut option. Or Ctrl plus X. Then fourth one, click paste option. So before that, one thing, click the cell you want to paste it. Then fifth one, click paste. Click paste option. So once again, moving data means we can move the data from one place to another place. There are some steps for moving data. First one, select the range of cells which you want to move. Second option, second step is click home tab. Under the home tab, there are some options. So click cut button. Cut button or press Ctrl plus C, Ctrl plus X. Then fourth step, click the cell in which you want to paste the data. And then go to home tab and then select or click paste option. So what happens? The whole data will be pasted on a new location without remaining it in the original location. Okay, so look at the page, look at the picture, page number 88. So here a table, it consists of two cells, class 9, 8, 10, then 12. So in the place, in the D cell, we can see there is also a list of students. It contains list of students. but we already cut from there so that there will be blank spaces. That means first it contain names list Arun, Ishi, Sabi and Anita, and then we apply cut option so that it will be disappeared from their original location and moved to new location. Okay. Then next is using auto sum. So next is what? Using auto sum. Okay, so auto sum means auto sum calculating the sum automatically. Calculating the sum. Here Australia. India versus Australia. And the score is 76. Next, India versus Sri Lanka. India versus Sri Lanka. And the score is 98. Next, India versus New Zealand. And the score is 134. Next, India versus Pakistan. And the score is 45. So here we have to find out the sum. So here, doctor. Then we have to find out the sum of these scores. So how to find out the sum of these numbers or the scores without entering formula? That means we do not need to enter any formula in this. Instead of that, just click on the auto sum. Click on the auto sum. So first, select all these values in the range of cells. Select all these values and then click which button? Auto sum. Which button? Auto sum. So total value will be appeared in the cell. So here click on an empty cell after the last entry of the range of cell. That means first, before click the auto sum, you have to click here. That means this is the last entry after the list of scores. So click here, and then second one, click on home tab. So second option, click home tab. Then third one, click auto sum. Then the formula for the sum of range of numbers above it will appear in the active cell. So we know this is the active cell because we clicked on it. And then the formula for calculating the whole numbers will be automatically appeared here, so that the whole number calculated value will be displayed on this cell. So steps one more, once more. First step, select the value. Select the value. Second one, select the value, and second one is what? Click home tab. Third step. Then click auto sum. So before that, just enter the or click the cell you want to find the, click the last entry of the last entry. Then click auto sum. So select the values, click home tab, click the last entry, click the auto sum. So what is the definition of an auto sum? An auto sum is a feature in MS Excel which provides an easy and quick method to calculate the sum of selected range of cells. Then our last portion, using the sort option.
Using auto sum options. So first, enter the name of students in the
here B1 means we know how to know the address of the cell. So B1 to D1, select the student's marks list and then enter the ending total. That means after that we have to find the sum of the marks. So you can enter data in the last entry, then place the cursor on B5, so you can get the score of all the marks list, then go to auto sum. Finally we will get the score of the whole subjects of IV, right? Then second one, next we want to find the sum of mark list of Ishi. So that just click on the last entry of the question and then go to auto sum. So what happens, we get the total sum of Ishi, total sum of that mark list. Then next to the same way we can get the mark list of Sally. Okay, so here our chapter ends. Then study well, we will continue with another chapter. Thank you.